Hi everybody, welcome back. Never done a competition, decided to do one. Hit 1 million views this week, excellent. So it's a giveaway. I'm giving away 4 sets of flies. Some of them are flies that a lot of people have seen just lately. They said, are you selling them? No, I'm not. I'm taking a month off for other reasons, but you can be the first to win these. And as you can see in the picture, some of them I've not even put up for sale yet. So it's a case of watch the video, it's not too long. How many fish do I hook into? Put it in the comments, give the video a like, and you're in the draw. Just a disclaimer, no one else will get in touch with you about this draw, only me, and I will contact the winner directly. If you get any other messages off anybody else or any other clowns on here, ignore it, and I will contact you to say that you are the winner. So I'll leave it in your hands. Watch, like, number of fish I've caught. The draw will be made at 6 o'clock on the 28th of January. Good luck, everybody. The competition starts as of now. Well, just to put a few people off, I'm going to do a little bit of a voiceover. This is probably my 4th or 3rd visit to Pennine. And as I say, I'm not one of these people that will go around and pester people and say, "Aye, what are you catching on? How are you? Blah, blah, blah." I actually quite straightforward went up to Andy as I booked in, being a novice here. That's a novice here. I'd fished elsewhere many times. And I said, "What's catching?" And he says, "Go in the corner on the pontoon, put a red apse bloodworm on." I had a very crude version of it, really did. And he says, just cast it out and draw it back as fast as you can, which I did. And on this day was a real red letter day. A red apse day, a red letter day for me. I hooked fish after fish after fish. This was on the same par as the pulling buzzer, because the pulling buzzer I used on the opposite side of the bank a couple of weeks later. If I'd have used this the following week or the week after, it probably wouldn't have worked. But ask the fishery manager what's catching. He'll know, it's his water. And he told me quite happily what would catch. So I took it on. And again, sometimes when I've been to this water before and I've seen Steve, what's catching, and he's told me. Sometimes I go there with what I'm going to fish straight away, but that's just to prove a point. When I've fished various buzzers, various leeches, a lot of people do come to this water with a particular fly in mind. That they always fish and they always catch. And good on them, love to see people catching fish. I just like to try certain flies that I look at in my box and I think, a trout would never go for that. I remember once I used a Hokey Dokey white body orange head and I got an 8-pound rainbow out on it. I couldn't believe it, it was massive. And that was on the opposite side of the bank up by the life buoy. You still keeping count, guys? Right, good. As I've cut, I don't get here all the time. I probably about 10, 15 times a year I'll come here. Brilliant little water though, absolutely fantastic. There's a few other waters I want to get to because I want to add a little bit more variety on my channel. And ideally, it's just the travel time. This place is only 20 minutes away from where I live. Same as Ryburn, that's only 5 minutes from where I live, 2 minutes from where I work. I do pop down to Barnsley once in a while. Hats off to these guys I watch on videos where they're getting up at 4 o'clock in the morning to drive 3 hours, 4 hours. But then again, here, I've had people get in touch with me the other week saying, "I'm coming from Scotland, coming down to fish here. Where can I park up?" And I've said, "Get in touch with Andy. He may be able to help you out." I know some guys that used to come from Newcastle and Liverpool on a weekly basis, they'd set off at daft o'clock in the morning, drive all the way down to fish here, just to get a fish of a lifetime. I know it's not a massive water, and some people will say, "Oh, it's put and take, put and take." Point is, it's difficult to fish here. If you go here fishing and thinking that you can catch fish on a particular type of fly, good luck to you, because you might have to knock the tippet right down. And I've heard and seen people get snapped constantly because they're like a 5-pound tippet. And if you're playing that fish, it'll just, many a time I've caught a fish, it's been a light tippet, idiot that I am, and I've gone, "Is this going to bolt it in a minute? Is this going to snap away?" Which it did. But once you do get that big fish on it, and it just starts dragging you around, and you net it, that's just made your day. Many a time when I've talked to people, the more they're willing to say, "Look at this that I've caught, look at this, look at that." But anyway, that's enough about me rambling on. Probably a lot of you thinking, "What's he talking about, the nutter?" Anyway, watch your total, put it in the comments, give it a like, and let's see who wins. But again, thanks very much. 1 million views for a little lad. on his days out. That is it. As I say, don't expect to learn anything. This is just me and my days out. And this year, me and my days out with a few of my old friends. One of them I've not seen for 28 years. But we're going to meet up soon. Anyway, thanks very much for watching, everybody. And I'll catch you later.